So far in these videos, we've been assuming that the three people running the MPC are all honest, trustworthy people. But what if one of them wasn't honest? What if one of them was actually an imposter? If the imposter can see 2 out of 3 secret shares of my secret number, is there any way for them to violate my privacy? As you'll see, there is not.
Okay, there are 10 possibilities for what the last secret share could be. And those correspond to 10 possible values for the secret number. So it looks like the secret number is somewhere between 0 and 9. Oh wait, I didn't learn anything. Oh. So I still don't know what the secret number is.
But how about the addition protocol? What could an imposter do there? In that protocol, the imposter needs to add up the numbers to one side. What if they added them up wrong? Adding the numbers up wrong doesn't help the imposter violate anyone's privacy, because they don't learn anything new by doing so. But adding them up wrong could mess up the computation and cause us to get the wrong answer. Fortunately, we can stop the imposter from messing things up. All we have to do is double check all the sums. We can just have the people running the computation add up both stacks of numbers that they can see. That way, they can double-check each other's work and figure out if anyone made a mistake.
Karta, you added the map wrong.
Oops, there was an accident.
How about the multiplication protocol? This one is actually the most interesting. At the very end of that protocol, when it's time to write their answer on a sticky note and place it on the table to the right, the imposter could write down the wrong number. Once again, writing down the wrong number doesn't help the imposter violate anyone's privacy, because they don't learn anything new by doing so. But it will mess up the computation and cause us to get the wrong answer. But I have good news for you. We can catch the imposter. We can add some extra checkpoints to our multi-party computation to make sure everyone followed the protocol correctly. If the imposter writes down the wrong number, then we will fail the next checkpoint, and the two honest people will know something is amiss. They can just abort the protocol when a checkpoint fails. The details of how these checkpoints work is kind of complicated, so I'll put those details in a separate video. In conclusion, there is only one way that the imposter can possibly violate my privacy, and that is to recruit a second imposter.
Hey,
yeah.
Can you tell me what the last secret share is? I can make it worth your while.
Ben, Karta is trying to bribe me to violate your privacy.
Uh-oh.
Here are the three main points I hope you take away from this video. One, if one of the three people running the MPC is actually an imposter, they can't violate your privacy. Two, if said imposter does the wrong things to try to mess up the computation and get the wrong answer, the two honest parties can tell that something went wrong and just abort. And three, the only thing that we need to trust is that no 2 of 3 parties are working together to violate our privacy. These are pretty strong security guarantees, and we can use an MPC like this to design a system that protects people's privacy with a minimum number of assumptions about the people who are operating it, because there's no single point of failure. That sounds like a pretty good system design to me.